Hi Olivia, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. I'm good. Today is the 3rd of November and it's This is Engineering Day, which is a day to celebrate what engineers do and kind of highlight their importance in society and hopefully inspire more young people to take up the career because of how important it is for lots of different reasons. So I currently work in the environmental sector, so I'm a sustainable waste consultant. And I studied chemical engineering at university in Edinburgh for 5 years, and I did my master's in Sweden. And I've always been interested in sustainability and greenness. People ask me kind of where that came from. I don't really know. It's one of those things that's always been there. I can't like pinpoint the moment where I was interested in it, but from a really young age. So that's always guided my career, kind of how I can equip myself to have skills and make changes that are better for the planet. And I didn't know what engineering was until I started looking at a university prospectus. It's not like I had family who were engineers. I think in my head it was kind of just mechanics and people who fix cars were engineers. That's kind of the extent of my understanding. And then I was reading university prospectuses and I found chemical engineering, and it felt like that was a degree that gave me the skills where I could make a real change and a real impact in sustainability. Originally, I wanted to get into renewable energy development. And even if I did change my mind all of a sudden and go, actually, nah, I don't care about the planet, it was still a really good degree to have because it's so, so useful in so many different ways. And it's about how engineering teaches you to think and solve problems. So yes, there is an element of maths and science, but it's also just a way of seeing the world and breaking down a problem and kind of finding a solution no matter what, that's really valuable for so many different things.
Yeah, thank you so much. That's really interesting. I was going to pick up on what you said actually about not really knowing a lot about it before and thinking it was mainly maybe to do with mechanics or using your hands, I don't know, to do with cars. And that's what I've previously thought in the past and what people that I've spoken to have thought. So do you think maybe, I don't know if that's part of the problem why there's maybe a shortage of engineers, because we don't know enough about it or we have certain stereotypes in our head of what we think it might be?
Definitely, I agree with that. So that I think there's a shortage of something like 59,000 engineers at the moment in the UK, and only 12% of them currently are women, and I think less than 10 are Black and from other minority ethnics. So there is a real lack of diversity in all senses, which I think leads to this stereotype problem. But engineering, so I think engineers that you see, may that be in media or just, you know, if you Google search quickly engineer, kind of what the images that come up are, definitely feed into that stereotype. But it is so much more than, I mean, you know, Formula One and cars are great, so that is part of engineering, don't get me wrong, but there is so much more to that, and it's, you know, so diverse. So I study chemical engineering, but there's aeronautical or space or kind of biomedical, which is, you know, you're making your body better, and software and design. And I think the main thing that you're not taught in schools is that there's so much creativity required for engineering. It's not just like a right and a wrong answer. It's maths and science. It is so much more creative than that. So there is a massive diversity of engineering types out there and things that you can do. But yeah, I think that image and the lack of value that people place, I think, on engineering in the UK, in some countries around the world, you're really highly revered if you study engineering, but I don't think that's quite the same in the UK, because we have that perception of, oh, it's just somebody who fixes things, which is really important nonetheless, but there's that sense of the value that engineers can bring. And, you know, engineers design and build the world we live in, so they're vital. So yeah, we need to appreciate that much more.
Exactly. Even what you're saying just now about like the creativity involved, or that it's not just, you know, math or science, it's like it seems like it's so many different things brought together that it uses so many different parts of your brain, so many different skills, that it kind of, it is surprising how more people don't want to go into it. But I think it is what you're saying for sure. And I was wondering, I mean, this is obviously quite a big question, but do you have any idea how we can change that or how we can sort it out? Obviously days like today are really important to draw more people into it, but yeah, do you have any idea? Yeah.
So I think, yeah, This is Engineering Day is really important. So that's been going since 2019, and there's been lots of different versions of the campaign. So one of them is videos about young people who are in various careers. The most recent one this year is Masterpieces, which is reimagining paintings of the past. So like Van Gogh, and how engineering of the future. So what that scene, what that landscape would look like in 2050, and how engineers could be part of building that future. There's been a campaign, I was talking about Google searches a couple of years ago, where it's just about taking loads of new pictures of the actual people who are engineers, as opposed to just random kind of like stock footage of people in high-vis jackets and hard hats. So I think This Is Engineering is massively part of it. I think it's about people, you know, I didn't come from a family of engineers. So had I not been lucky at school and had teachers and careers advisors who were open to engineering and understood what engineering was, I might have been put off. I think that's really important that teachers kind of reassess and understand what engineering is. And I think it's also about people who are already working as well. You know, you can relearn to be an engineer later in life and come back into that field. And it's so important. Specifically, I was talking about sustainability and climate change. So to meet all these net zero targets by 2030 or 2050, we need like so many more engineers than we have now. So it should be all hands on deck. So I think it's all hands on deck. So I think it's like a multi-pronged approach of all those things.
Definitely, because I was going to say what you just said about net zero by 2050, potentially. I was reading about This Is Engineering Day, and it seems like it won't actually be possible unless we get more engineers or more people on board who care about the climate, which is obviously why it's so important and it's so vital. And do you think, because I'm learning so much just from talking to you right now, do you think a big part of engineering and why people want to go into it is to do with climate change and helping the environment and stopping, you know, being more sustainable? Is that a really big element, would you say?
Definitely. I mean, I'm obviously biased because that's why I did it. but I think more and more, and I think that also encourages a greater diversity of people. I think more women and more people from different parts of the world are more likely to be involved in engineering. If it's about saving your planet, that social aspect and designing something that's better for everyone, I think that's really important. And from a purely practical perspective, we're not going to get anywhere near net zero without a lot of engineers. So there's also incentive from the government to make it more attractive for people to study and stay in engineering. So may that be salaries or supported education, or different routes of education as well. I went to university, that's not for everyone. In some ways, had I known that there was other options out there, you start to think, well, would I have actually gone to university, or would I have done an apprenticeship or something else? So I think that's a big part of it. And just realizing the breadth of jobs involved. So very practically, everyone talks about heat pumps that Boris Johnson had in the news recently and changes to your houses. So that's something that engineering and skills will have to be involved in. But then there's kind of the big scale, you know, system redesigning of the whole system that needs to be a part of that. And I think that can't be done with engineers, but I think it's also really important that the engineers that doing that are from a breadth of society, because otherwise you'll be designing something that only works for a certain group of people. So I think we've got to, it's not just loads of people do it, it's like making sure there's the breadth of people doing it as well. And I think it's about realizing that, you know, life is hard for loads of people, and we are responsible for designing a system that makes it as simple as possible for people to do the right thing regardless of what they've got going on. So I think the biggest thing in the UK is we've got different bins everywhere in the country. So I've moved from Reading to Edinburgh to Bournemouth to Bristol, and everywhere's got a different recycling system. So how am I meant to know what bin to put things in if you're moving around a lot, if you have a transient lifestyle? So I think that's the most important thing I've learned around, you know, being so close to what real people, you know, people do, is, you know, don't take anything for granted, and it's our job to make things as user-friendly as possible. And I don't think that's always the case.
Thank you so much. This has honestly been so informative and so interesting. Thank you for coming to speak to me, and happy This Is Engineering Day.